नक्की मराठीमध्ये एक पिक्चर करणार कमीत कमी लवकरात लवकर
लवकरात
लवकर. बेसिकली देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ प्रेशर एस्पेशली ऑन मी एस्पेशली ऑन सोशल मीडिया गेट अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल से सर तुम्ही मराठी पिक्चर करणार का यु नो दॅट काइंड ऑफ सो आई सेड नो
ही मराठी शी इज तमिळ
आई एम
टेक पंजाबी
हाफ पंजाबी
आई एम हाफ मारवाडी हाफ पंजाबी
सो वी आर गोना कवर
यू नो सो
सो वी आर गोना कवर
बट इन माय ओपिनियन फार अवे द मोस्ट इवॉल्वड एट द स्क्रिप्ट लेवल cinema without a doubt is the Marathi
industry.
Outstanding.
Yeah.
It's just another level of I mean the kind of subjects that they will pick up and they become commercial successes is unbelievable that there's an audience out there that will you know go and pay for a ticket and you know and watch something like this so which is very gratifying and I think therein lies the challenge because you see most Marathi cinema it's not like it's a compromise you know you look at it, it's technically still very good at script level is very good everything is up there and the performances are beyond first rate So I think it's extremely challenging to be able to pull something like that off. We are actually in the process of working on one Marathi film right now, which Swati is spearheading. Although she has limited knowledge of Marathi, so she's come to me for.
but
she's found a very interesting idea that we're working on, and let's see. Hopefully, all goes well.
Yes.
Now again, it's the script.
Having said that, the one thing I will say is, very often we get asked, why aren't you doing Telugu cinema? Why aren't you doing Tamil cinema? I think there are enough more people in that market, you know, who are doing extremely well for themselves. There are established production houses, you know, who've been doing that for 20 years and 30 years, you know, in Hyderabad and you know in Chennai. You know, so I don't think we consciously want to, you know, get into a market for the sake of getting into a market. You know, I think there are enough and more stalwarts in Telugu and Tamil. That's not to say we're saying no to it, but I think there are many stalwarts in that market who are doing a very, very commendable job. I think Marathi is close to home. It's close to us. Also, like Atul said, I think
okay.
it's...
Marathi, bol dono.
Well, I mean, we live here. That's the closest we get to Marathi.
No, Tanu, say something in Marathi.
I thought you said English speaking. Say something about South Bombay. Of course you can. Say something.
So,
food related. Do you have food on you? That's why he said ikde.
And also, I think from all the regional industries, I think this is going to sound very, very parochial and biased if I say this, but I think of all the regional industries, I think Marathi is really proving to be the it most evolved and educated in that sense. You know, so I think it sort of is the closest to our sensibilities and the closest to our ethos. Years back, about 5 or 6 years back, there was a whole spate of sequels that came, and none of them worked. I've actually personally been a part of two sequels that didn't do very well, or as well as anticipated. You know, I think those were the times when people thought that sequels were a ready-made formula for success. You know, that people would blindly come to watch a sequel because the original was a hit. You know, and I think it sort of busted a lot of myths over there because a lot of people realized that just because it's a sequel, it doesn't necessarily have to be a good film. You know, so there was this entire period between 2009 to 2014-ish, 15-ish, where there were a bundle of sequels that came out, and I think with maybe one or two exceptions, a lot of them didn't actually work. I think what happened at that point of time is that a lot of filmmakers sort of took the audience for granted. They said, you know what, let's just take any story, chipkao the same cast, you know, put the original per title, add the number 2 or 3 to it, you know, and bingo, you have a hit film. I think those rules were promptly quashed and thrown out of the window by the audience because they were inherently not good films, you know, so they didn't work. Having said that, I think having a brand definitely helps. It definitely adds value. There's no doubt about that. And it's something we consciously look at, you know, even when we sort of identify a script, not that that's any criteria, but we do sort of see, does it have franchisable potential? Will it have sequel value? And that could be one of the many criteria that we would look at, you know, to sort of evaluate a script, but definitely not the deciding criteria for sure, you know. So,
and the story has to lend itself naturally to a sequel,
either
you know,
to a
or
sequel,
a prequel.
Yeah, from a continuation Correct. Perspective or
and
from an installment perspective, you know. So, I think also the other thing is in our industry, very often people don't get the difference between a sequel and an installment. you know, a sequel is very different from an edition or an installment, you know. So a sequel, true to its literary meaning, is a continuation, you know.
Yeah.
Whereas an installment is basically just sort of using the same name and building a different story around part 2, 3, 4, 5, you know. I think doing an installment is relatively easier than really doing a sequel, you know. Because for a sequel, the story has to organically flow. I mean, of course, we can't do a sequel to Neerja because she's dead, right? But, you know, but as far as, you know, let's say a Tumhari Sulu is concerned, very often people ask us, you know, will you do a sequel? You know, I think we discuss amongst ourselves, a sequel, I don't think so. An installment, maybe. You know, so
we'd like to if it works.
We'd like to attempt it. Yeah.